It has been a minute since I have seen you. Yes. How are you? Well, you're not perfect if you're here, right? I heard that you made an appointment, and I believe it's not your, obviously, your regular checkup. So, what can I do you for today? I see you took a tumble. Maybe, yes. Well, I don't have gloves on yet, so I will not inspect, but yeah, I can see that we have to take a look. Okay, yeah. Of course, I'm glad you came in. It's better to be safe than sorry, at least in this field. You never want to take a risk when it comes to your health. Okay. Wonderful. Well, I have my notepad right here. I can see that all of the assistants are very busy right now, so I can just jot down your information. Then we can head over to the room and I will get started on. Just have the general basic information. So, full name. Okay. And your date of birth. Okay. And your phone number. Changed your phone number. See, this is good. This is why we ask this each time, just in case there are some changes. Great. Okay. And an email. Okay. Wonderful, wonderful. And the name of your insurance. Any allergies to any medication? No. Any new changes in the medication you are currently taking, if any? Okay, no. And your appointment was in 3 weeks, correct? Yes. It's 3 weeks. And do you want to change that, or do you still want that to be? Okay, we'll keep that. Yes, just in case. Okay. Great. So we have all that taken care of. So now we can get started and check out to see what's wrong. Okay. Great. Okay. I will start by taking your temperature. Okay. So we have our little temperature thing here. This may seem a little old school. I kept this one. I secretly asked to have this kept in my office because I believe that this thermometer is actually very, very efficient. Okay, so this is what it looks like. Opens like that. Okay. So we're just gonna turn it on and wait for it to be ready. Okay, it is ready. So just tilt your head at an angle for me. Okay, that way, that works great. Okay. Now this won't hurt her. The other ear, just so we can get a correct reading. Okay, you ready? Okay, great. Your temperature is normal, so that's good. Was everything other than our little incident here? Good. Yes, we're getting some remodeling done at the moment, so that is exciting for all of us here. Okay, now we are going to, I'm gonna put on the gloves and just start doing the normal checkup just to make sure all your vitals are good. I think you know the drill, but just in case. So we have our gloves here. So we'll take some out. They're very stuck together. For this, I'm just gonna put on the mask just in case of anything. Okay. Yes, even if you think that you do not have anything. So why don't you tell me about exactly what happened? Okay. 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 So you were sick and fell and then took that tumble. Okay. Yeah. So. Yes, what you had, dizziness and fainting is very common with the flu. With the flu that you got, yes. So, I know that you were taking your antibiotics, but just in case, we're gonna make sure that that's all gone. I know I didn't see you for that, but I am just going to make sure that that is all gone, and then treat this little wound up for you. And then we should be okay. Okay. Got our gloves on. Okay. And now I'm just gonna be going testing your ears. I'm gonna be looking at your eyes, up your nose, and in your mouth, okay? Okay. We'll start with the ears first. So I have my light. Nothing will hurt, so we're gonna start with this ear. Okay. That seems good. Okay. Be using the scissors just to clip away at some of the hairs that I'm seeing there that has a bunch of wax buildup on it, if that's okay. me know if I pull too hard or anything. Okay. We don't need this mask quite yet. Those masks are actually a lot hotter than they seem. When you're sick, you obviously get a lot of buildup, including in your ears, your nose, your throat, especially with the flu. Yeah, unfortunately. So I am glad you came in, just so we can clean up everything that needs to be cleaned up. And these scissors are just very good to get in through the hairs and see your actual eardrum. And make sure that everything's okay in there as well. Okay. I think we're good with that ear. Now we're gonna move on to your other ear here. Okay? Same thing, same process. Maybe. Okay. I see some as well in here. Sorry for being very up close and personal, but unfortunately this is what the doctors have to do. Okay, I'll tug on your ears a little bit. Make sure you tell me if they hurt. All good? Okay. Lovely. Now, we're gonna take a look in your eyes. Alright. I'm gonna start with my right. Okay. Okay. Other eye. Can you follow the light for me? Okay. Wonderful. Okay, now we have to take eyes are looking great. Great color, by the way. Okay, now I'm going to put on my mask and we're going to take a look in your nose and your mouth, okay? Oh. They fall sometimes, but that is okay. This again, and I'm just gonna ask you to tilt your head up, and I'm gonna look at your nose, okay? Okay. I do see some buildup in your nose, but that should be cleared up with the antibiotics that you have. Last but not least, let's take a look in your mouth, okay? Okay. Say, ah. Okay. Can you stick out your tongue for me? Thank you. Your throat is looking pretty good. I know you're throwing up a little bit, but it's looking pretty clear. Your tonsils, still a little swollen, but that is expected. I say all in all, your vitals are very good, getting back to normal, very strong and healthy. But I know that is bothering you. So I'm gonna give you another dosage of the antibiotics that you were taking beforehand, just so we can make sure this doesn't happen again. Okay, great. Other than that, I can just get you bandaged up. Little thing right there, and then you'll be on your way. Awesome. Okay, gotta leave these on. So, I will be cleaning with this lovely hydrogen peroxide, 3%, for treatments of minor cuts, oral. Or you can, yeah, so this is good for anything. I guess we always have a big, big jug of this around for little scrapes like these that you can get. So we're gonna just use some cotton balls, okay? Great. Don't worry too much. I know, I can see the look on your face. It's a little worried. It doesn't sting too much. You might feel a little sting, but it's nothing horrible. And it's not like your cuts are very open. They're more so scrapes. Yeah. Okay. Did you fall outside? Okay. So there might be some pieces of gravel stuck in there. Dirt. Yeah. Yes, this is definitely needed then, okay? Alright. So we'll take in our little cotton ball and we'll just Is that okay? Yeah, see, not too bad. Okay. Okay. can't prevent the little accidents in life, right? Unfortunately. But that's what I'm here for. To take care of you. Okay. Let's pick out the little pieces that I'm seeing. Move on to the other side. See, everything's okay. Everything's good, right? Okay. I see a little bit right there on your cheek that we can get, okay? About does it. I think that looks good. Yes, it is time to bandage them up. I was hoping that you wouldn't mind. All I had left were little kids' band-aids. Little minion ones. Yeah. I was hoping. And they are small enough that this will work. And there's two. Okay. Now. Start with one on your forehead. Put it on the other side of your forehead. No more falling, okay? Because then I'll have to get you a box of these band-aids. Does that feel good? Great. Okay. I will just put in that prescription, the refill for your antibiotics, and you're all set. Believe it or not, that didn't take too long. Great. Okay, feel better. Please call me if anything changes, or if you fall again, or if you need anything else, really. It's so nice to see you, but don't come back until your appointment.